tutorial shows a genuine way of using Lightroom sliders directly within Final Cut Pro. It's an intuitive way for photographers to get started in Final Cut Pro with the color grading knowledge that they already have. And that means if you're used to working in Lightroom, there's no need to relearn your entire workflow. And let me explain from the outset, this is not just a conversion of Lightroom presets into LUTs by just copying the Lightroom presets. These are actual sliders within Final Cut Pro. Also, let me point out, these sliders don't do anything that can't already be done by Final Cut Pro's own color correction tools. It's just a different way of doing the grading. But the sliders do have the advantage of not only being familiar to photographers coming to Final Cut Pro, as I've said before, but they also give an intuitive way of correcting color that may not be that obvious to new users of Final Cut Pro's wheels. The sliders are what you'd find under the Development tab within Lightroom, and they're available as three separate plugins or as a bundle. Check in the description below for the code that'll give you a 10% discount on purchase. The first plugin is the Basic Controls, and these are the same as Lightroom without the histogram, though this can be brought up in Final Cut Pro with the video scopes. So looking here, it's best to hide the browser from the window menu. If you're a photographer coming into Final Cut Pro, let me emphasize this before I go on. Video files aren't photographs, which means that video files can't be controlled as aggressively as you would do with photographs in the Lightroom application. That's because video files are a lower resolution than the photographic images that you're used to working with when you've used Lightroom. Video footage will break apart if you drag the sliders too far. But you can get the same look from plugins in Final Cut Pro. It's just that the position of the sliders may differ in comparison to where you'd be used to having them in the Lightroom application itself. Anyway, these are the basic controls. You can select color or black and white, as in Lightroom. And the white balance is the same with manual controls for temperature and tint. With temperature, move to the right and you get yellow. Move to the left and you get blue. And it's useful to know that the sliders all allow keyframing, and the curly arrow will return the individual sliders to a zero setting. Click the reset parameter to return all of the settings to zero for that plugin. And if you want to look at the pre-graded video clip without the sliders effect, then click the blue tick in the checkbox. Now under the tone heading. This is basically everything inside the histogram that's not related to color. Rather, it's only looking at the blacks, the whites, the highlights, the shadows, and the midtones. And I feel there's a more intuitive control of whites and blacks than you'd find in Final Cut Pro's color wheels. But that's just a personal impression. Presence has two controls, vibrance and saturation. Vibrance is changing the settings in the midtones, and saturation is the overall intensity. And a tip, lift the vibrance and reduce the saturation rather than lifting the saturation. It'll give you a much more natural feel to the image. And next is the camera calibration plugin. As a simple explanation, camera calibration is how a camera interprets the RGB in every pixel of an image. And it's confusing because it's done differently by different camera manufacturers. The controls here mean that the Lightroom calibration tools allow you to change how the primary RGB colors are handled by different camera types. So to be clear, you're not changing the mix of the colors, you're actually changing the ingredients of the colors that are being presented to you. This is different from the HSL controls, which you'll see in a minute, where the resulting color itself is mixed. And here's a video that discusses the concept in more detail. Now the HSL plugin. And these will also be familiar to Lightroom users, but just as a quick explanation. Hue changes the actual color in the clip. and there's a number of tones of color other than just the primary RGB colors. And these can be particularly useful for lifting the color in clouds. Saturation changes the intensity of the color. And luminance is the light showing in each of the colors. It makes that color lighter, but it doesn't affect the actual intensity of the color itself. So I hope these simple explanations help you understand the concept of these three new plugins. And for those of you that are already Lightroom users, that you see the advantage of being able to apply your knowledge to color grading in Final Cut Pro without having to learn the new tools like the color wheels. The annual plan from Adobe for Lightroom is $9.99 US per month. The full Forevermore price for the Lightroom Controls and Final Cut Pro, the bundle's €35, that's about $40. They're available for both M1 and Intel Macs. Check in the description below for the code that will give you a 10% discount on purchase. I'm here to help, so if you need assistance on a specific topic in Final Cut Pro, I offer free support via email, and that's for urgent issues that you're confronted with. Click the I above for the link to my free support site. Otherwise, let me know in the comments below about topics that you struggle with, and I'd be happy to produce a YouTube video to help you solve those issues. And don't forget, I'm also available for one-on-one internet training, trainingfinalcutpro.com. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't done so already, please like, subscribe, and press the bell.